Hey guys, this is Matt Brunet, and welcome to Movie News Weekly, hosted by Filmbook. Now, before we begin, let's take a look at what we got in this week's news, which includes racing at the box office, ready for round two, Netflix on the big screen, the new girl of Deadpool, Depp's new partners, the next Spider-Man trilogy, the new leader of the Dark Phoenix, Sony learns not to be stupid, Hulk vs. Gawker, and Kilroy was in Florida. So with that said, let's get things started. Even in his old age, McQueen still got some moves. Cars 3, the latest installment of the popular Pixar franchise, managed to get up into first place at the box office this weekend by getting around $53.5 million. The only downside to this start is that this is the lowest opening for a Cars movie, since the first began with $60 million and the second opened with $66 million. Meanwhile, the previous top holder, Wonder Woman, had to step down into second place so that it could grab less than $41 million. The other new movies this week decided to stay within the odd numbers while the old ones stay even. The Tupac biopic, All Eyes on Me, started in third with $27 million, while 47 Meters Down began a little low in fifth with about $11.5 million. Behind The Mummy, which went down to fourth on its second weekend with about $14 million. The new film that suffered the most this week was actually Sony's female answer to The Hangover, Rough Night, since it only started with $8 million behind Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales, which is in sixth with about $8.5 million. In case it ever happens, she's ready. When talking with Conan O'Brien, Patty Jenkins revealed that if Warner Brothers has any plans to create a sequel to their recent film adaptation of Wonder Woman, she would immediately be willing to do it. Jenkins stated, "It's amazing because it feels like a long time coming, and I know that I wished a movie had happened a long time ago, for many other reasons, but it feels like it hit the perfect pocket, and I've loved that people have embraced it for that reason. And also, even the fact that Wonder Woman stands for love and truth, it's hitting home really hard that she is a superhero for everyone." When the movie opened in theaters back on June 2nd, it started off with $103.3 million at the box office during that weekend, making it the biggest opening for a movie ever directed by a woman. Who needs streaming when you got the big screen? Netflix has announced that they will be releasing Bong Joon-ho's Okja in selected theaters in New York, Los Angeles, and in the UK. The plan is to release the film simultaneously as the global release on the online streaming service. Some of the theaters presenting it include iPIC, the Film Society Lincoln Center, and LAML. The story of Okja is about a young girl who would do anything to save a giant pig creature from a company taking it away. This year, it was one of the two Netflix movies that was presented at the Cannes Film Festival with the Meyerowitz stories, and it ultimately received great praise from critics. Okja will begin by appearing in theaters in the UK on June 23rd, while the American cities will be prepared for it on June 28th. Why not spice this recipe up with a bit of Japanese flavor? Shioli Kutsuna, who was recently seen at Cannes in Oh Lucy and next to Jared Leto in The Outsider, has been announced to appear in Deadpool 2. Neither Fox nor Marvel revealed what role she will play in, but they did confirm that it will be a big one. Kutsuna will be joining alongside other newcomers like Josh Brolin as Cable, Zazie Beetz as Domino, and Jack Kesey, while appearing alongside others who have returned like Ryan Reynolds, Marina Bakarin, Leslie Uggams, Stefan Kapakic, and Brianna Hindelbrand. The first Deadpool movie was recognized as a landmark film in 2016 and became the highest-grossing R-rated film of all time with $783 million at the global box office. The second film will be hitting theaters on June 1st, 2018. Here's some help for you, Johnny. IM Global has signed a first-look deal with Infinium Nihil, the production company made by Johnny Depp. The deal will be to both finance and co-produce Depp's comedy drama, Richard Says Goodbye, which will be directed by Wayne Roberts. Stuart Ford, the CEO of IM Global, stated, Johnny is, of course, a globally recognized superstar, but, as importantly, we at IAM Global love Infinium Nihil's idiosyncratic and taste-driven view of the movie-making world and the unique brand that Johnny, Christy Dembrowski, and their team have developed. We're building this relationship in order to generate great movies for the global audience with a like-minded creative partner. And with IAM Global's reputation as a company that has enjoyed frequent successes greenlighting both films outside of the confines of the major studio system, I feel certain that our newly extensive filmmaking partnership with Infinium Nihil will be a fruitful one. When Depp will be done with Richard Says Goodbye, he will be reprising his role as Grindelwald in the sequel to Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. Whoops! Well, there goes the surprise. In an interview with All Cine, Tom Holland accidentally revealed that Spider-Man Homecoming will be a part of a trilogy. Holland stated, "There is still a lot of room for Peter Parker and Spider-Man especially to grow in the next two movies." After he realized his mistake, he would later explain a bit more details about it. Spider-Man is definitely not the finished article by the end of Spider-Man Homecoming, and I really look forward to explaining the different ways he can grow up and go through puberty, I guess. It's going to be an exciting couple of movies. Yes, there'll be a Spider-Man 2 and 3. It won't be Homecoming 2 and 3. Sony Pictures nor Marvel has yet to confirm if they are planning Spider-Man as part of a new trilogy. This will be a part of Holland's 6-movie contract where he will appear as the web-slinger. He's already done Captain America Civil War, and the other 5 movies will most likely be that trilogy and the 2 Avengers Infinity War films. Looks like we got a lot more stuff happening after the apocalypse. Simon Kinberg has signed on to be the director of the next X-Men movie, Dark Phoenix. It was also confirmed that some of the cast will be returning as well, like Alexandra Shipp, Cody Smit-McPhee, James McAvoy, Jennifer Lawrence, Michael Fassbender, Nicholas Holt, Sophie Turner, and Ty Sheridan. Also, Jessica Chastain is in talks with Fox to play the villain in the feature. Not only will Kinberg direct the feature, but he will also be writing and producing it, along with producing other Marvel films from Fox like Deadpool 2 and X-Men: The New Mutants. Although this will mark the directorial debut of Kinberg, this will not be the first time he will be working on an X-Men film, since he was the writer of The Last Stand and worked on the screenplay and produced the movies after that. Dark Phoenix is scheduled to be released on November 2nd, 2018. Well, I gotta hand it to them, at least now they're acknowledging their stupidity. Sony Pictures has backed away from their plan to create a clean version of some of their lineup of features in order to make them more family-friendly. Some of their films they wanted to censor using this new program include the Spider-Man movies, the Ghostbusters films, both Grown Ups, Step Brothers, and Talladega Nights. Both filmmakers and the Directors Guild of America expressed much distaste to this new plan, especially when the guild mentioned that it would violate their agreement. Matjit Singh, the president of Sony Home Entertainment, stated, "Our directors are of paramount importance to us, as we want to respect those relationships to the utmost. We believe we had obtained approvals from the filmmakers involved for use of their previously supervised television versions as a value-added extra of sales of the full version. But if any of them are unhappy or have reconsidered, we will discontinue it for their films." While the DGA is happy to know that the clean versions are scrapped, they will be keeping an eye on Sony to make sure they won't make that mistake again.
Whatcha gonna do, brother, when Hulkamania slams the press?
The Hamptons International Film Festival has announced its lineup of the Summer Doc Series, a special segment of the festival dedicated to presenting documentaries. The artistic director of the festival, David Nugent, stated, "This year's series truly includes something for everyone, from debates about free speech, an exploration of the trophy hunting industry, a pop star's triumph and struggles, a riveting sports scandal, and a profile of a surfing pioneer." With a number of special guests set to attend, and engaging discussions flowing each screening, we are thrilled to share these films with our audiences. The first documentary it will present is Nobody Speak, Trials of the Free Press, which will take an inside look at the legal battle of Hulk Hogan and Gawker by Brian Knapper Benger. Other documentaries it will present include Trophy, Take Every Wave, The Life of Laird Hamilton, Whitney, Can I Be Me, and Icarus. What began as a little talk from his podcast now turns into an entire feature. Kevin Smith began the filming of his next horror film, Kilroy Was Here, at the Ringling College of Art and Design in Florida. The students of the college have been confirmed to give a helping hand into the production. Smith stated, "This is a monster movie in the sense of a classic morality tale. No one wants to see you spill the blood of innocence. But when somebody crossed the line and goes bad, you got to make them pay in horrible ways." And the audience cheers. "We wanted to make an anthology film in the veins of Creepshow. Kilroy is like the Golem, the Boogeyman, and the Grim Reaper combined." The phrase "Kilroy Was Here" originated as an iconic piece of graffiti during World War II, depicting a bald man with a big nose looking over a wall with his fingers clutching it. And that's all I've got for this week. Thank you guys so much for watching, and don't forget to head on down to film-book.com for all the latest movie and TV news, along with their columns on the box office and their theatrical release schedule. Also, you can follow them on whatever social media you'd like. And while you're at it, you can follow me on my YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter if you're more into stuff like animation, Disney, and my weird sense of humor. If you are watching this on YouTube, then hit that like button and come subscribe to us, and also leave a little comment on what you think on the news this week. If you are listening to this on a podcast on iTunes or any other podcast service, then don't forget to rate and review what you just heard. Tune in next time for another round of Movie News Weekly, and until next week, see you later, dudes!